Hello everyone, Kai here, and today I'll show you guys how to add powerhouse for a game. This will be the first video to welcome our year 2023, and I hope this year we can finally achieve our 1000 subscriber goal. And let's begin the process. As we all know, power-ups are crucial for our game. It helps the player become more powerful, and that's why we need them. Because what is a game without power-up, right? Let's start by making a cube to start to wall ourselves up. Let's create a material for our power-up, and you can choose anything you like, but I'll go for the bluish material of some sort, just like that. We also want this to be a speed multiplier so our player can go fast, because, you know, slow is boring. No one likes being slow. Let's also scale it down and move it towards the player, and just like that. You can also make a jump or strength move if it suits your game, then optionally add an icon by creating a canvas inside it, adding a panel, and plastering an image of an arrow boost on it. And there you go! Getting an image to Unity, it's very straightforward. Seriously, just go to the internet, download, drag it to Unity, change the file type, and put it in. Now to the actual ability boost script. First, let's create a C# script, then delete the entire edge script. Just kidding, just start method and update method. After that, add an onTriggerEnter method, and so we can detect if whenever the player touched the power-up, and actually go back to the editor and turn on its trigger. Heh, my bad. Add an if statement, so if other.name equal to our player body, which you can of course change the name player body to any name of the player collider. And now let's make the mob power up self-destruct, so whenever player collides with it, instead of staying there, which is a very illogical thing to do, it needs to self-destruct. It needs to destroy game object, and that's it. Let's go to our player script, and note that the player script can be your own one, and set a variable movement speed to static public. So now we can access from this script that we just created. So whenever the player collides with the power up, we'll multiply the speed by 1.5, or the movement speed by 1.5. You can also create a public variable so you can adjust the multiplier, and let's replace the 1.5 with our multiplier. And that's it, and it's just that simple. So let's run the program to see if it's working. And of course, it's working flawlessly. And an optional part is you can also change the camera FOV, and to do that, you just need to get to do public camera, and let's name is camera FOV, and then go to our onTriggerEnter and camera FOV dot field of view, and will equal to 100, because it makes our game looks like it's being faster. And so now, after we save our script, let's drag our camera, player camera in, and if we test the program, you'll see that it's working flawlessly as expected. Phew. And that's all. I hope you all enjoy this New Year's video, and if you watched till the end, you might be interested in a video above. I'll see you guys there. See ya.